So good morning, dear children.
Good morning, ma'am.
I hope you are all thorough with the revision. You all have revised the last lesson, that is lesson 15, going downhill on a bicycle. That's the workbook exercises, and have come ready for the revision test today. Yes.
Okay. Yes, we are ready for revision.
Okay, okay. Nice to hear that. So, shall we start oral revision? Okay, we'll start with the oral revision. We'll do the revision of the lesson first, lesson 15 first. Then after that, we will do the revision of the workbook exercises. And after that, I'll be sending you the link of the revision test. Okay, and with that, we will be completing the revision of all the lessons and exercises for the MCQ 3. Right? Okay, yes. Now, the first question, what is the boy doing in the poem? In this poem, what is the boy doing? Yes, Ojas.
The boy is riding a bicycle.
The boy, where? On the road?
Downhill.
Yes, the boy is going downhill on a bicycle. What is the boy doing in the poem? The boy is going downhill on his bicycle. Very good. Now, what is the name of the poet of going downhill on a bicycle? What's the name of the poet? Avantika.
Henry Charles Beeching.
Henry Charles Beeching, or shortly known as H.C. Beeching. Okay, good. Next. Can you give me the one word which means in a ready position? In a ready position. Yes, Mayuk.
Poised.
Poised. Please spell it.
P-O-I-S-E-D.
Yes, P-O-I-S-E-D. Poised means in a ready position. Next, what do you mean by the word? Very good, Mayuk. What do you mean by the word heedful? Aryan.
Alert and attentive.
Excellent. Alert and attentive. Because as I said, in this poem, you have just three new words to learn the meaning. Only three new words have been introduced in this poem. So alert and attentive is called heedful. Very good. Next question. How does the air go? How does the air go? Yes, Siddhi.
The air goes by in a wind.
Excellent. The air goes by in a wind. The air goes by in a wind. Now, to whom does the boy compare his joy? To whom does the boy compare his joy? Adi, Adidev.
His mother.
What is the answer of that question?
The boy compares his joy to the bird.
With the bird. Very good. That's the correct answer. He compares his joy with the bird. Now, what do you mean by the word dart? D-A-R-T, dart. Yes, Riza.
Move quickly.
Very good. Move quickly. The boy darts downhill with a heedful might. And he's poised. He's poised to dart downhill with a heedful might. Okay, very good. Now, rhyming words. I'm going to write. And you need to tell me which is the rhyming word. Okay. Okay. Swift is the word. And you have got here three options. Still. Fly. Lift. You have to tell me which is the rhyming word of Swift. Okay. Juan.
Ma'am.
Which is the rhyming?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, lift. Ma'am,
yes, with the answer.
Ma'am, lift.
Yes, lift is the rhyming word of the word swift. So as you know, rhyming words are words that end with the same sound. So in that case, lift ends with the same sound as swift. So they are rhyming words. So I guess this is all what I have to ask from this question, from this lesson.
Because
it's just a short poem, and just one more question. What is a boy's position? What is a boy's position before he goes downhill? Aditi.
Ma'am, before going downhill, the boy feet are lifted off the cycle pedals and his hands are still.
Yes, hands are still. Very good. So that's it. I don't think that we have any more questions from this poem. Please make sure that you don't get confused with the meanings of these three words, poise, dart, and heedful. And of course, what is the mood? What is the feeling of the boy as he goes downhill? Is he, I'm not giving you the option. Can you tell me what is the feeling of the boy? Who can give me the answer? Yes, Felix. How does the boy feel? And what is his reaction?
The boy's heart is filled with joy.
Yes.
And he is very careful.
Yes. The boy's heart is filled with joy and he screams out, right? With excitement. So that's it. Okay, now we will move on to the workbook exercises. Yes, Felix, that's it.
Going downhill. When he's going.
Okay. Okay then. So let's start with the workbook exercises, revision of workbook exercise. And in the first module, we have the usage of the words two, and as I said, these words are called homophones because they are homophones because their spelling, just a moment, though their spellings and meanings are different, they sound the same, right? Two, okay. Now I'm going to read out the sentences. You have to be very attentive and you have to tell me which two you will be using in that. So for convenience, I'll put 1, 2, 3. Okay, these are the three twos that you are going to use. So listen to these sentences. The first sentence is, climb dash the top and wave the flag is on. Climb dash the top and wave the flag. Which two will you use?
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
Should I write it on the board? That will be better, right? So, climb dash the top. Yes. And which one?
The first one.
Yes, very good. The first one, climb to the top. So here, these three twos have got different meanings, right? The first one has got the meaning of a preposition. It is a preposition and T-O-O, what does that mean? It is another word which can be used instead of also. And T-W-O is the number name of the number two. Okay, fine. The next question, Sarah, listen, look at the board.
Okay, ma'am.
He has eaten dash much this time.
Second one, ma'am.
Which one?
Second one.
Perfectly right. Double T-double-O. That means he has eaten too much. Here, this two means excessive, more than enough. Okay, so T-double-O have got two meanings. One is either also, or the next meaning is excessively, more than what is required. And here, that is inferring the second meaning, too much. He has eaten too much this time. Very good. Now, the next one is, question goes to Navneet. His father came home and gave him dash oranges. Can you tell me which two will you be using here? Which one?
Two.
Which one?
T-W-O.
T-W-O. Here it infers the number two. Two oranges. Okay. Next one. Ashwell. Ravi likes dash come back home. I'm not going for the remaining part of the entire part of the sentence. From this, the meaning will be clear. Yes, Ashwell, which two would you write?
T-O.
T-O. Very good. Likes to come back home. Okay. Then, next one. I was invited, Ryan, this is for you. I was invited to a party and my sister was dash. Which two would you write? I was invited to a party. Party. Maybe my writing is not that neat. Party. And my sister was two. My sister was dash. Which two?
T-O-O.
Exactly. T-O-O. Here it shows the meaning also. The sentence show that I was invited and my sister also was invited to the party. Very good. And we took a trip dash Ladakh. This question is for Navneet. Navneet, which two will you write here? We took a trip dash Ladakh. Which two will you write there, Navneet?
Two.
Give me the spelling.
T-O-O. No, ma'am. T-O.
T-O. Okay. The preposition to will be used here. Okay. So, with these examples, I hope you are confident in using the right to according to the sentence. Read the sentence. Please understand the meaning and make sure which to be written. Okay. Resource it properly there. The next one is words related to art. This one I'm going to ask you just, I'm not going to write because as we have done the crosswords, but here only the clues will be given. Srihari, the question is, what is the word and the clue is done with a camera? Done with a camera. Do you want me to give the clues now?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Wait. Done with a camera. I'll give you the clues. Music. Photography, dance.
Photography.
Yes, photography is the right answer. Rudra, next one. Made with a pencil. Okay, the question is made with a pencil. I'll give you the option. Song, music, sketch.
Sketch.
Sketch is something done with a pencil. Very good. And next question is nice to listen to. Nice to listen to. Okay. Selin, the options are dance, painting, music. So even that exercises quite easy, I guess, right? It's all easy. And then let's move on to the final vocabulary exercise, that is the usage of again homophones. They are homophones. Yes.
There.
So what's the difference in the meaning of these three there's? First one is a contraction of the words they are. Okay, contraction of they are. The next one is the possessive word there, something that belongs to them. So that shows there. And the next one is a demonstrative word there, talking about a particular position or place. So I'll start with the examples. The first one is, he is fond of dash chicken. Instead of tikka, I'm writing kebab. Okay, so this one is 1, 2, 3. Okay, who can answer this question? Janvi.
Second
one, yes, their chicken kebab, because this shows something that belongs to them. Very good. The next one, once upon a time, dash lived a greedy king. And this question goes to Alessandra. Alessandra, can you tell me what will be the word, which there will be written there? Once upon a time, dash lived a greedy king.
Second one.
There lived a greedy king. You mean
third one. Third one.
Yes, third one. Be careful, okay? Because all the three words sound the same, but they are entirely different from each other. Because the spellings are entirely different and so the meanings. So you have to be very careful when you choose the word. Okay, the next one is, they have a good time dash. Maria, which there will you write there?
Third one.
Third one. Here also we use the third there. Okay. Next one. Dash very angry with you.
No.
Ridvi.
They are very angry.
So which one? First one, second? Yes. We are using the contraction. They are very angry with you. Okay. And one more example. It was dash idea. This question. Yes, I want Glenn to answer this question. It was dash idea to go to the fair. Yes.
Ma'am, it was their idea. Second there.
Can you spell it?
T-H-E-I-R.
Perfect. T-H-E-I-R. Their idea to go to the fair. And I guess with this, all of you might be thorough with this exercise. So in the workbook, we have three types of exercise. One is entirely different, that is crosswords. And the clues will be given. You have to find out the word. And it's quite simple to find out the right word from the three options given. And the next two sets of exercises are based on some homophones. First is the usage of 2, 2, 2. And the second exercise is based on the usage of the homophones there. And both these exercises, you have to be careful. First thing is that you should be knowing the meaning of all these words. And then look at the sentence and understand the meaning and use the correct word without mistake. Okay, don't do it in a haste. So is there any doubt regarding this lesson 15 and the vocabulary exercises? If you have any doubt, please ask now, because I'm going to send the link of the revision test. Is there any doubt, children?
No.
Huh? Is everything clear to you?
Yes.
Okay, yes, fine. So shall I send the revision test link now?
Yes.
Please close your workbook, textbook, notebook, and keep it aside.
Yes, ma'am.
And children, if you have missed out any notes or you don't have the notes of any of these three lessons, please check our website. I have uploaded all the notes in our website. Okay, so you can get the notes. Okay, so ready? There are 20 questions, 20 questions, and obviously the number of questions from the workbook exercises are more because the lesson 15 is very short. So I have given just a few questions from the lesson. All the remaining questions are from the workbook exercises. So,
when the names?
Huh?
When did the exam start?
Which 16th. One? 16th. Yes. Didn't you get the timetable?
Yes.
And our exam and our literature exam is on 22nd, I guess. It's on 22nd.
Yes.
Okay. So here is the link.
Malayalam.
Tomorrow exam start.
Yes. Ma'am. I'll send the link. Please do it.
I got it.
I have kept you unmuted, but please make sure that you mute your audio. If there is any doubt, please unmute your audio and ask.
Mom, can you send the link again?
Sure. Okay, fine. Got it, Alessandra? Take time and do it, okay? Don't do it in a haste.
I can't do
what happened, Mala? What happened? It's not logged into your account. Manav?
No, ma'am, we're logged in.
Then what happened? Just try it.
No, ma'am. I'm not.
Can you read the 7th question?
Sure. Seventh question. Air. The word air rhymes with. Look at the three options. Which is the word from the three options that rhymes with air? Hridvi, is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Flower.
Who is that?
Ma'am, Kirtana finished. Kirtana.
And what about?
Ma'am, Siddhi finished. Full. India top
full. Finish. Okay, okay.
Ma'am, full.
Full. Siddhi also got full. Very ma'am. Good. Mm.
Ma'am, full.
Full. Very easy, right?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I cannot click the 15th question's answer.
Ma'am, 15th. I got full. Okay, okay. Congrats. 15th. Why only 15th? Others don't have that Siddhi. Issue, right?
Yeah, ma'am. We don't have an issue.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes?
I'm the test. I got full.
Very good. So when you come for the MCQ 3, make sure that you go through all the revision tests of all the three lessons, including today's. And that will help you to understand your mistakes if you have made any. Okay.
Ma'am.
Correct your mistakes and prepare for the MCQ 3. Yes, Nainika.
In last class, ma'am, there was any revision test.
Yes, my dear.
I do not attend last class.
But it was given in the group.
Yeah.
Immediately after the class, I had put it in the group. Why don't you check the group?
Ma'am, I finished.
Okay.
Ma'am, I finished, ma'am.
Whenever I take any test, the same day, I forward the link in the group.
Ma'am, I finished and I got full.
Very good, very good. Very, ma'am, yes.
I also finished. I saw the link in the
Manav, group. Manav,
yes,
could you do it?
Yes, ma'am.
You could do it. Okay. So what was the problem?
Again.
Ha ha ha. Okay, fine.
And I got full mark.
Oh, okay, very good. Why you not well? Manav? Not well?
Ma'am, I got 20 out of 20.
Okay. Good. Ah. Very good, Navneet. Okay. You ma'am, are sounding very tired.
I got full mark.
Full marks. Very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, children. So please do it. Those who have not submitted, do it at your own pace and submit. Okay. Is there anything you would like to ask me? Any doubts? Anything? Any clarification regarding any of the lessons? I hope all the portions of MCQ 3 is thorough for you, right? Now, the only thing you have to do for the exam is just revise it again.
I got full mark, ma'am. You told to do
link again.
Okay, huh?
Ma'am, you told to do.
Send the link again.
Yes, yes, sure, sure. I'll send the link.
I got full mark, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Very good.
Ma'am, you
One at a time. If everybody starts together, how can I hear? Who was asking something? Yes, Srihari.
Ma'am, I got full marks.
Okay, okay, very good. Yes, Aditi.
Ma'am, my exam is at 22nd.
Yes, 22nd, 22nd. Yes, Manjima.
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
Yes.
What happens when the boy goes sister and yet more sister?
The answer is given, right? What happens? I had given the answer in the notes. His heart fills with joy. He screams out. Somebody give the answer. Anyway, that question is not included in this test. Yes, Manav. Manav, give the answer. Clarify it to Manjima.
The boy's heart is filled with joy. He flies like a bird and he laughs out loud.
Okay. Is that clear, Manjima? Thank you, Manav. Manjima, is that clear? Huh, that's it.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, children. So I'll wind up the session. So anyway, if you have not received the link or if there are any absentees out there, I'll send the link in the WhatsApp today itself. Okay. After a few hours, I'll send it in the WhatsApp. So please do keep revising the lessons. And one thing you have to take care of is when you come from the MCQ, please don't forget to go through all the questions of the revision tests. Okay, you won't be able to do it again, but of course you can go through the questions. And if at all, if you had made any mistakes, you will be able to see your mistakes and the correction also. So please make sure that you prepare. The final revision preparation should be from the revision tests. Okay, all the three. I guess now I have conducted three revision tests of three lessons plus the workbook exercises, including today's. Yes, Aditi.
Ma'am, how many questions will be there?
For the exam, 20 questions. Only ma'am? 20 questions. 20 out of 20.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So thank you, children. Thank you all. Prepare well for your exams. Bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Bye.